Hello everybody, I am Baljit Dhaka from Pinnacle Coaching Center, and today in this presentation we are going to discuss paper code 731. 731 is previous year question paper. That paper came in 2015, 25th October 2015. We are discussing each and every question of that paper. As you know, this is a series of previous question paper in which each and every question of Tier 2 of previous year we will discuss. So in this particular presentation we will discuss question from 51 to 75. Already we have done two parts, that is we have covered question from 1 to 50. In this presentation we will cover the third part. Now question number 51 is, if a man starts from a place P and reaches the place Q in 7 hours, P to Q 7 hours, he travels 1/4 of the distance at 10 km, let's say total distance is x. So x by 4 he is travelling, this is that x by 4 distance, and he is travelling at 10 km per hour. You can say 10 km per hour distance divided by speed, that is time, and remaining distance is 3x by 4, and that is covered in 12 km per hour. Distance divided by time, total time is 7 hours. This is the equation, that is, this is the question according to the statement which we have made. Distance divided by speed, total time is 7 hours. So it should be equal to, you know, let's take LCM, that is 80. So 2x plus 5x is equal to 7. You can say 7x is equal to 7, x would be equal to 80, because 7 will cancel to 7, x would be 80, total distance is 80 km. Answer is B. Next question, question number 52. If O is the circumcenter of a triangle, let's say this is triangle and this is circumcenter. Circumcenter means a circle circumscribed about the triangle, and this is O. You can make like this. ABC is lying inside the triangle, and then OBC, this is A, B and C, then OBC, OBC is plus BAC, BAC. So we have to tell this angle and OBC, that is this, sum of these two angles. So in such kind of question, what should you do? You should always put value. For example, let's say take, this is 40. If this is 40, this would be also 40. Reason is that these are radius, so it would be isosceles triangle. Now if this is 40, this is 40, 40 plus 40, 80. So this would be 100. This would be 100, because 180 minus 80, that is 100. And if this is 100, then this would be equal to 50. Why? Because the angle formed at the center is double as compared to angle formed at the circumference. If this is 50, then this would be 100. Now this is 50 and this is 40, then it would be equal to 90. If you take here 30, 30 plus 30, that is 60, it would be 120, and it would be then 60. So 60 plus 30 would be 90. Well, whatever the value you want to put, you can put. Answer would be the always same. Answer is B. Next question, question number 53. The simple interest on a sum of money is 8 by 25 of the sum. If the number of year is numerically half the rate percentage per annum, then the rate percent per annum would be how much? So rate percent R is equal to SI into 100 divided by P into T. So SI is given here 8. 8 into 100 divided by principal, that is 25, because simple interest on a sum of money is 8 by 25 of the sum. If sum is 25, principal is 25, then rate of interest, then interest is 8 rupees. So SI into 100, principal into, and what is the next? The number of year is numerically half. Means if it is R, then it would be R by 2. R by 2, you can take here 2. The rate of per annum, rate percent per annum we have to tell. We have to tell the value of R. So R square would be equal to, this would go this side. So 8 into 8. R would be equal to 8. Answer is A. Next question, question number 54. In triangle ABC, BAC is 90 degree, AD is perpendicular to BC. If BD is equal to 3 cm and 4 cm, then the length of the AD we have to tell. Now, let's say this is triangle ABC, A, B, and C, and AD is perpendicular to BC. AD is perpendicular to BC, and BD is, this is, BD is 3 cm, and then CD, this is CD, not CM, CD is 4 cm. This is 4 cm, then the length of, this is CD, 4 cm, then the length of AD would be, we have to find the value of this. Suppose this is, for this BDA, in this triangle, BDA and BAC, these are similar angle. The reason is that this is 90 degree, this is also 90 degree. This is common angle, so third angle would also be same. So this triangle BDA and BAC are similar. Now this is perpendicular in BDA and this is perpendicular in BAC. So perpendicular, you can write here 3 by x. 3 by x means perpendicular divided by hypotenuse. And in this case, perpendicular divided by hypotenuse. X divided by hypotenuse, that is 7. That is 7. In BAC, perpendicular is x, hypotenuse is 7. So x square is equal to 3 by x square is equal to 21. X is equal to root 21. Now if this is 21, this is root 21, then according to Pythagoras theorem, then 21 square of this minus square of this, that is 9, would be equal to 12, and root of 12 would be the length of a base in case BDA. So answer is root 12. Answer is root 12, that is 2 root 3. 2 root 3 is the answer. Answer is A. Now you can also remember one important property. If you have to find the value of AD always, you can directly multiply 3 and 4, and then root of this. So BD and DC, root of that would be the your answer, AD. This is always true. So remember this property also, otherwise you can find the value. If you have experience, you can easily find in 10 second answer of this question. Next question, question number 55. Three glasses of equal volume contain acid mixed with water. The ratio of a acid and water is 2:3, 3:4 and 4:5 respectively. Content of these glasses are poured in a large vessel. The ratio of acid and water in the large vessel would be how much? Content of these glasses are poured in a large vessel. So let's say 2:3. 2:3, that is 2/5. If total is 5 mixture, then 2 is acid. 3/7 and 4/9. If 9 is total, then 4 is this. So total here acid would be equal to, and divided by this would be, we will find acid, and divided by 3/5, because this would be water. Out of 5, that is 3 is water. 7, 4/7 and 9, 5/9. So this would be water and this is acid. Now calculate this, you will find you can take LCM, and then you will have 126 plus 1435 plus 140. That should be equal to Let's say now you also find this 315 and then 189 plus 180 and plus 175. So 315 cancel, then we will have 126, 135 and 140. So that should be equal to now 35 plus 40, 75. 75 plus 26, that is 101, and 300 is already there. So 401 with the asset. Now in this option there is only one which is 401. So there is no need to calculate. Otherwise you can calculate, you will find the answer. Answer is D. So what we have done in this kind of variety, this is important variety, you must remember that. What is this? We have to find the value. If this is three mixture case, this is three mixture case, and if you have to find three mixture case, then you should always try to this. So note down this variety, this is important variety. When you have three mixture cases and you have to find water acid or water ratio in this format, you then always do this. This will be a better way. Next question, question number 56. If AB is 2 is to 3, BC is 3 is to 7, then AB, BC and CA ratio we have to tell. So A and B, that is 2 is to 3, and C and B and C is 3 is to 7. So A is 2, B is 3 and C is 7. You have to find the value of A plus B, that is A plus B is 5. Ratio, 5 ratio, you have 5 by 7, right here, 5 by 7. BC is 3 plus 7, that is 10, and CA is 7 plus 2, that is 9. So 5, 10, 9 should be the answer. Answer is D. Very easy question. Question number 57. Numerical value of the volume and area of the lateral surface of a right circular cone are equal. If the height of the cone be h and radius is r, then the value of 1 by h square plus 1 by r square is. Try to understand this question. Pause the video, try to solve this question. 1 by h square plus 1 by r square. This should be equal to h square and r square, then r square plus h square. R square there and h square. So this is r, this is h. H square and r square, that is equal to l square. So what is the question? Numerical value of volume. Numerical volume means 1 by 3 pi r square h is equal to area of lateral surface of the right circular cone are equal. Area of lateral surface means pi r1. Means curved surface area, pi r would be equal to, then you can cancel this, r you can cancel to r. So as this this should be equal to l by you can write here l by rh, and that is equal to 1 by 3. L by RH is equal to 1 by 3. Now this put value you can put in this. It means L square would be equal to, this is equal to L square, and this is equal to R square into H square. So this should be equal to 1 by 9, because square of this would be equal to this. So what is the question? We have to find the value of this. So this should be equal to 1 by 9. Answer is C. Next question, question number 58. 102 places P and Q are 162 km. P and Q 162 km. A train leaves P for Q. A train leaves P for Q, and simultaneously another train leaves Q for P. One train is going to this side, another train going to this side. They meet, it means they are going in opposite direction. They meet at the end of 6 hours. If the former train travel 8 kilometers faster than the other, then the speed of the train would be from x would be how much? they meet at the end of 6, or if the former train, that is train P, if P is travelling at the rate at X, let's say Q is travelling at X because P is faster and P would be X plus 8. P is faster, that is X plus 8, Q is travelling at the rate of X kilometer per hour, then P would X plus 8. So both speed will be added when they are going in opposite direction. So total distance is 1 by 62 divided by 2x plus 8 speed, distance divided by speed, that is time which is 6 hour, time which is 6 hour. So this should be equal to, you can say 12x 48 would be minus 48, that should be 6, then it would be equal to 19 by 2. 19 by 2 is the value of X. 1 by 2. Answer is A. Next question, question number 59. If tangent theta minus cot theta is equal to 0, tangent theta and minus cot theta is equal to 0, in other words, you can say this is 45 and this is 45, then it could be 0 because this is equal to 1 and this is equal to 1. 1 minus 1, that is 0. Then the value of A, we have to find the value of this. So 45 plus 15, that is tangent 60 is root 3, and 45 minus 15, that is 30. Tangent 30 is 1 by a root 3. So value of this would be equal to 3. Answer is D. Next question, question number 60. The portion of a ditch 48 meter long, 16.5 meter wide and 5 meter deep that can be filled with stones and earth available during excavation of tunnel, cylindrical in shape of diameter 4 cm and length 56 meter. Length 56 meter. So the portion of ditch 48, it means portion means total, this is the bigger volume, you can say 48, volume of this would be equal to 48, 16.5, this should be equal to, you can write 60.5 directly, and then 4 meter, then 4 meter. So volume of this and volume of this which is cylindrical in shape would be 22 by 7 pi r square. R is equal to diameter, that is 4, r would be 2 into 2 r square, and h is length which is 56 meter. So volume of cylinder divided by volume of this tunnel would, we will get the portion of the ditch which will be filled. So in place of this you can write here 10 in place of decimal, so this should be equal to 2 by 9 should be the answer. 2 by 9 part will be filled by this cylindrical shape excavation. Next question, question number 61. And in this question it is given, if x cube minus y cube divided ratio x square plus xy minus y square is equal to 5:1, then we have to find x square minus y square is ratio x minus y 7:1. Then the ratio of 2x and 3y would be equal to how much? This is in fact plus. So see, this is the formula, x3 minus y3 is equal to x minus y x square plus y square plus xy. This is the formula of this. Now if I take to this side, then it will be equal to x square plus y square plus xy. So this would be equal to x minus y. This is equal to this. this formula is according to this. So x minus y is 5. 5 divided by 1, that is 5. Now x square minus y square, you can say x square minus y square would be equal to x plus y and x minus y, and divided by x minus y, that is 7 by 1. It should be equal to x plus y, that is 7. X plus y, that is 7. So 2x is equal to 12, x is equal to 6. X is equal to 6, then y would be equal to, y is equal to 1. X 6, y 1. We have to find the value of a 2x plus 3, ratio 3y. So 2 into 6 into 2, that is 12, and 3 to 1, that is 3. 3 into 1, that is 3. So 4 is to 1 should be the answer. Answer is B. What we have done, we have just put the question number 62. So x is equal to root a plus 1 by root a, because this would be equal to 1 by 2 is equal to root, and if it is minus, then it should be in this format. And y is equal to root a minus 1 by root a. X plus y would be equal to 2 root a, because this will cancel. And x minus y then would be equal to, then it will become plus, so it will cancel root a and by root a. So 1 by root a and plus 1 by root a, this would be equal to 2 by root a. 2 by root a is the value of x minus y. Now see this expression. According to this expression, if you open this bracket, you will find x 4 plus y 4 minus x square y square and x square y square. This would be equal to 2 x square y square. Minus 1 and plus 1, it will cancel. So this is equal to x square minus y square and whole square. And you can say, you can write this expression in this format, x plus y, x minus y, and whole root 2. X plus y, that is 2 root 2, 2 root a, and x minus y, 2 divided by root a, that is equal to 4 and whole square. 16 should be the answer of this question. Here is the answer. What we have done in this question, we have just put the value, first value of x and y, x plus y and x minus y. We could find like this. Now the next question, question number 63. Question is, mark price of a tape recorder is 12,600. A festival discount of 5% is allowed on it. Further, for cash payment, this is cash payment, a second discount of 2% is given. The cash payment is to be made for buying it, is would be how much? So 12,600 into 95 by 100, and again 98 by 100, because 2% is the discount. So total would be in this format, 12,600, that is, and then it should be 19, this would be here, and here it would be 20, then 10, 63, so 63 into 98. It should be 6,300 minus 126. That would be 6,174, and multiplied by 19, divided by 10. It should be equal to 11,730.60, because 0.6 in place of, and due to this 10 divided by 10, you can write here 0.6, and then 60 paisa. 11,730.60, A should be the answer. Next question, question number 64. If a man walks at the rate of 5 km per hour, he misses a train by 7 minutes. However, if he walks at the rate of 6 km per hour, He reaches the destination 5 minutes before the arrival of the train. Distance covered by him to reach the station would be how much? So in such kind of way, you can take LCM, let's say total 6 kilometer and 5 kilometer. 30 kilometer is the total distance. Take LCM and 30 kilometer. 5 kilometer per hour, it means he will take 6 hours to travel 5 kilometer per hour. And with the 6 kilometer per hour, he will take 5 hours. So if the difference is 6 hour minus 5 hour, that is 60 minute, then distance is 30 kilometer. But here the actual difference is 7 plus 5. Why 5? Because this is minus. He misses a train by 7 minutes. It means 7 minutes is the difference here. And here 5 minutes earlier. Total gap is 12 minutes. Total gap is 12 minutes. So 12 minutes if the gap is, then the distance would be 30 by 60 into 12. That is 6 kilometers is the distance. Answer is A. Next question, question number 65. If x minus root 3 minus root 2 is equal to 0, y minus root 3 plus root 2 is equal to 0. So x would be equal to, in this expression, root 3 and plus root 2, because this will go to this side, and y is equal to root 3 minus root 2, when this value will go to that side. So x plus, here we have to find the value of this x3 minus 3, open this bracket, then we will have x3 minus 3, and then again here minus 22 root 2, minus 22 root 2, x3 and minus y3 is equal to this, and we have given the value of this. So what we can do is that x minus y and cube of this would be equal to x3 minus y3 minus 3xy and x minus y. If I put this value to left side, then we will have x minus y cube, and then 3xy x minus y is equal to x3 minus y3. So in place of this I am writing this expression, because why, it is easy to write. X minus y would be equal to, here x minus y would be equal to root 3 plus root 2 minus root 3 and plus root 2. That should be equal to 2 root 2. So x minus y is 2 root 2. And x into y would be, because we will also regard x into y, this is equal to root 3 plus root 2 into root 3 minus root 2. A plus B, A minus B, that is A square minus B square, 3 minus 2, that is 1, which should be equal to x, y is equal to 1, and x minus y is equal to 2 root 2. So x minus y cube, that is 2 root 2 plus 3xy, in place of y you can write 1, 3 into 1, and then x minus y, that is 2 root 2. And here we have written in this expression, in place of this, and then minus 22 minus root 2, because we are filling this value in ultimately in this expression. So it is equal to 16, because 2 power 3, that is 8, and root 2 power 3, that is 2 root 2. So 16 root 2, and then this is 2 root 2. This is x minus y, that is 2 root 2. So 6 root 2 minus 22 root 2. 16 plus 6, that is 22 root 2 minus 22 root 2, that is equal to 0. So answer would be, in this case, 0. C is the answer. Next question, question number 66. Now the question is, if the radii of two solid iron spheres are 1 cm and 6 cm respectively, a hollow sphere is made by melting the two sphere. If the external radius of the hollow sphere is 9 cm, then its thickness would be how much? These are two sphere, 1 cm, 6 cm. So volume would be equal to volume would be equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. You can write pi r cube 1 and then 6 or 3. This should be equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. In place of this, you can write here 9 power 3 and minus x cube. You can write here minus x cube. Now, these are two sphere. So, sum of these two volume of these two sphere is equal to the external volume minus internal volume. That is 9 cube minus x cube. So, you can cancel to this. Then we will have 217 is equal to 9 power 3, 729 minus x power 3, that is x3 is equal to 217, then it would be equal to 512, that is 8 power 3, x is equal to 8. So the internal radius would be 8, external radius is 9. So the difference is thickness, the difference would be 1 centimeter. Answer is 1. Next question, question number 67. In this question, there is wooden sphere of radius 4 root 3. This is sphere 6 root 3. Surface area of the largest possible cube cut out from the sphere. So, largest possible cube would be the radius, you can say the diagonal of the cube would be equal to diagonal of sphere is 12 root 3 and diagonal of cube is always root 3a. So, side of the cube would be 12, surface area of cube would be 6a square. So 6 into 12 into 12, 72 into 12, 864 is the answer. 6a square is the surface area, because we have to find the value of surface area of the largest possible cube cut out from the sphere would be how much. Next question, question number 68. If 60% of A is equal to 30% of A, 30% of B. So, you can say 2a by b is equal to, a by b is equal to 1 by 2. B is 40% of a c. In other words, b by c is equal to 2 by 5. We have to find the value of a c. So, a by b into b by c, it is equal to a by c. And which should be equal to 1 by 2 into 2 by 5, that is 1 by 5. So, if A is 1, B is 5, A is 1, B is equal to 5. In other words, C is, this is only C, C is 5, A is 1, then C is 5. So, C is X percentage of A, it means 5 times. If I multiply it by 5, then it will become to this. So, this is equal to 5 times means 500 times, 500%. Answer is B. Next question, question number 69. A and B can do a piece of work in 30 days and 36 days respectively. They began the work together, but A leaves after some days and B finishes the remaining work in 25 days. After how many days A leaves? So, total work, let's consider it 180. So, in one day, A will do 6 unit and B will do 5 unit. They begin the work together, but A leaves after some time and B finishes the remaining work in 25 days. It means B is doing 25 days. It means 125 unit he has done alone. 125 days. 55 unit they have worked together. 55 unit divided by 6 plus 5. That is, they are doing together 11 units in one day. So, they work 5 days together. After how many days A leaves? 5 days they work together and after that A leaves. So, 5 should be the answer. Next question, question number 70. A sum of money placed at the compound interest, double itself in 5 years. Let's say 100 rupees becoming 200 in 5 years. It will amount to 8 times itself in the same rate of interest. So 200 will become 400 that in the next 5 years, that is 10 years, and 400 would become 800, that is 2 times in next 5 years, that is total 15 years. So 15 years would be the answer. Next question, question number 71. Question: a quadrilateral ABCD is circumscribed about a circle. This is circle and this is quadrilateral. This is quadrilateral. This is quadrilateral and this is circle. If the length of AB, you can take it A, B, C and D. Length of AB, BC and CD are respectively 7 cm. AB 7, BC 8.8 and CD that is 9.2. Then the length of DA, we have to find the value of this. AD, we have to find the value of this. Suppose this is, this is equal to x. Let's say, let's I write here D E F E F G and H G and H. I A F is equal to x. Let's say A F is equal to x. Then A H would be equal to x. Why? Because from these are tangent. A F A E and A H are tangent and they have equal length from the same point or point outside the circle. So similarly, then this would be equal to BE is equal to 7 minus x, 7 minus x, and BF 7 minus x, this would be equal to 7 minus x because BE and BF are equal, so 7 minus x. So 8.5 minus 7 minus, it will become plus. Then it would be equal to, we will be able to find the value of this. This should be equal to 1.5 plus x. So CF is equal to 1.5 plus x. It means C and G would be this because this is equal to this. So 1.5 plus x is the value of this. So the value of this would be equal to 9.2 minus 1.5 and minus x. Minus x, in other words you can say 9.2 minus, then we will have 7.7 minus x. This is the value of a D and G. And so this should be equal to 7.7 minus x. So 7.7 minus x and this is plus x, which is equal to 7.7. So AD would be equal to 7.7. Answer is C. What we have done in this question, A, B, C, D, this is equal to 7, 8.5 and 9.5 and x. We have divided E, F, G, H. Why? Because this is the point where you will find this and this is equal to this and this is equal to this and this equal to this is equal to this. Why? Because these are tangents and from the same point outside the circle, tangents are have similar same length. So this would become, then if this is x and total is 7, then this would be 7 minus x. This is also 7 minus x. 8.5 minus 7 minus x would be equal to, would be the value of this 1.5x. This would be also 1.5x. So 9.2 is total minus 1.5 plus x would be the value of this. This is equal to 7.7 minus x. This is also 7.7 minus x. So this would be plus then 7.7. Otherwise, you will keep in mind, if you find such kind of question, keep in mind that that the difference of this, that is equal to 1.5 and minus from this 9.2 minus 1.5 is equal to 7.7. That would be the answer. Difference of this, you then subtract from this, you will get the answer. Remember in this, remember this trick. Difference of this, which is equal to 1.5, and subtract from this, you will get immediately answer. This is very important trick. If you don't want to solve like this, otherwise you can solve. But sometimes generally question is repeated format. You can find the change in value only. Otherwise you can find all the same value. You can find such kind of question like this. Question number 72. A right prism. Question is, a right prism has a triangular base whose sides are 13, 20 and 21. If the altitude of the prism is 9, then its volume would be how much? Volume is always, this is prism. Prism is considered analogous to cylinder. This is like this prism. This is prism and base is triangular and volume is area of the base into height. Area of a base into height is the volume, and area of the base is, this is scalen triangle. So area of scalen triangle would be 13 plus 20 plus 21 divided by 2, that is 7 parameter. 21 plus 13 and plus 20 would be equal to 21 plus 34, 34 plus 20, 54 divided by 2, that is 27. 27, so S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. If this is A, B and C in this format. Now 27 minus 27 into that is 14. You can write here 14 directly. 27 into 14 into right here 7. 27 minus 20, that is 7. 27 minus 21, that is 6. So root of all these would be equal to, you can write here 2 into 7, 7, and here you can write 3 into 2, and here 9 into 3. So root of 9 would be 3. This and this would be equal to 3. 2 and 2 would be equal to 3, 2, and 7 into 7 is equal to 7. If we do the root of this, then we will get this. So 3 into 3, 9, 9, 120 should be the value of area of this. So area of the base into height, 126, and height is given 9. Height is given 9. 1134 is the answer. Answer is A. So what is the volume? Volume of prism would be area of the base into height and area of scalen triangle, we can find by using Heron formula like this and multiplied by height. Next question. Next question, question is 73. Question is 300 gram of sugar solution has 40% of sugar. 40% means 40% of 300 would be equal to 120. So 1 out of 300, 120, that is 40%. 40%, 120, and this would be 180. This is sugar. And this is, you can say, water. Water. How much sugar should be added to make it 50% in the solution? 50% in the solution, that is, 1 is sugar and 1 is water. 120 plus x divided by 180. You have to add sugar so that it can become 1:1 ratio. So 120 plus x is equal to 180, x is equal to 60. If I put here 60, then it will be equal to 1:1. Answer is A. Next question, question number 74. Question is, the area of isosceles trapezium is 176. What is trapezium? Trapezium is like this. Trapezium would be like this. 176 centimeter area of this would be. And height is 2 by 11 of the sum of its parallel side. Sum of parallel side means A, B, C and D. AB plus CD. If the ratio of the length of the parallel side is 4:7, that is, this is 7, then this would be equal to 4x. If this is 7x, you can say this is 4x. and this would be equal to 1.5 and 1.5x, because this is isosceles. Isosceles means these two sides would be equal. This two sides would be equal. Then the length of the diagonal would be how much? So area is 176, which is equal to 1 by 2 sum of parallel sides, that is 7x plus 4x, 11x into height. Into height. Height is 2 by 11. 2 by 11 of the sum of its parallel side. Sum of its parallel side, that is 11x into 2 by 11 of a sum of parallel side. Now 2 cancel 2, 11 will cancel 11, and 11 this cancel would be, that is 16, x square is equal to 16, x is equal to 4. So value of this is 4 into 4, that is this side is 16 and this side is 28. So this would be 6, because 1.5x would be equal to 6, and this would be 6. This would be 6. So we have to find the value of a what is the length of diagonal. Diagonal is this or this, length is same. So this is equal to 2 by 11 into sum of its parallel side, that is 11x. 11, and you can write here 4. So this is equal to 8. This is equal to 8. 2 by 11 into 11x. X value of x is equal to 4. So this is equal to 8. We have now value 8. Here this is 28 plus 6, that is 34. So 8 square, that is 64, and 34 square. This should be the answer. So this should be the answer. This is not 28, this would be, that is, this is 4x. So 16 plus, this is in fact 16 plus 6, that is 22. 22, here it would be 22 by 2, 22 square, because this value is 4x and this is 2x, so 6x. 6x would be 20, 16 plus 6, that is 22. So 22 square, that would be 484 plus 64, you will have 548. Root 548, that should be equal to 2 root 137, because it will divide by 4, and if we divide it 4, then we will have 137. So it will be 2 root 137 A is the answer. Next question, question number 75. What is the question? There are two circles, 11 centimeter radii, 6 centimeter radii. PQ is A and B is the center, A and B, and PQ is a direct common tangent. PQ direct common tangent, that is PQ. If AB is 13, AB is 13 means the distance between these two center is 13, and this is 11 and this is 6, and the distance is total 13. Then PQ is direct common tangent to the circle. Length of PQ we have to tell. We have to tell the length of P and Q. This we have to find. What is the formula of direct common tangent? You just remember the formula of direct common tangent, and that is L is equal to distance d square minus r1 and r2 in case of a direct common tangent. And that should be equal to 13 square, that is 169. You can write here 169, because this is 13 square, minus 11, 11 minus 6, that is 5, 5 square, that is 25, 11 minus 5, 11 minus 6, that is 5 square, and it should be equal to 144. Root of 144 is 12. So 12 is the length of a direct common tangent. Answer is B. B should be the answer in this case. Now in this way we have covered question number from 51 to 75 in this presentation. Thank you very much for watching this presentation. All the best.